above the skies. Surreal experience after surreal experience, Chris and Lucario sat down on a corner of the small machine as they felt the occasional rumbling movement of the cruising UFO. It was a miracle that Juff was... It was a miracle that Juff was quickly learning how to operate the Skyrunner, as Dr. Andernuts completely forgot about making instructions on the go, or even an instruction manual. A nearby sticky note on the control panel read, "Nobody reads this manual anymore. Nobody reads the manual anymore these days, and won't do that in the incoming years." Those were wise words, since Chris himself never bothered to read them unless it was very necessary. Ironically, the situation was asking for a manual of sort. That's not irony. But Juff had everything under control. Trying to forget about their worries, the duo looked outside through the small windows at the clouds. They were riding in a UFO, but that didn't make the scenery outside any less enjoyable. The clouds outside were being touched by the light of the sun. Since winters was a particularly cloudy region, going further away reduced the cloud mass as holes in the sky started to appear, making the sunlight rays look majestic in a way. "I was scared about riding in this ship," Chris said, but it's so amazing to look outside and watch the clouds." Lucario kept a tight grip on Chris's smaller body, pulling him to his side with one hand. Sensing the calming aura from his trainer and seeing the small bright smile on his face, the aura Pokemon felt at peace.
"I agree," Lucario said. "This is also my first time flying through the sky." "This is also my first time flying through the sky."
Wrong emphasis. Chris looked up and chuckled, leaning his head against Lucario's furred body.
"Hey, this is one of our first times doing something new together," he pointed out. Lucario chuckled.
"It's very refreshing to experience something like this for the first time together," he admitted. "For that, I'm grateful."
"I wish I could stare outside," Juff spoke from the control panel. "Sadly, my dad didn't build an auto-control option for the Skyrunner. I'm slowly figuring out how to operate everything. We're lucky that 3'd is far away from here, though I theorize we'll get there in an hour or so if we keep up the same speed."
"And Ness is there,"
Lucario thought. His trainer also realized the gravity of the situation. Ness was the reason why Master Hand sent them to his world. Keeping him safe from the army would be easy with Lucario, but Chris wasn't so sure if they were up for it, judging how they had screwed up very early. Moreover, Ness was the leader of a group of chosen children. Convincing him would be another ordeal to pass. More lies were needed to keep their charade up, unless they figured something out first. Juff was just a stepping stone for what was to come. The duo fell silent and, exchanged wordy glances.
"How are my two saviors doing?"
Both of them gasped loudly when they heard a mental scream inside their heads. Juff looked back at them. Maybe it was Crazy Hand. Give me a second. It was Master Hand.
"How are my two saviors doing? Blah, blah, blah. Is something wrong?
Let me just try and read this bit again.
How are my two saviors..."
Both of them gasped loudly when they heard a mental scream inside their heads. Juff looked back at them.
"Is something wrong, you two?" he asked. "We're not crashing into an airplane, right?"
No, Chris muttered. We just...
"Realize we haven't eaten in a while,"
Lucario finished, faking looking ashamed.
"Yes, we're starting to get hungry."
"Unfortunately, the Skyrunner also lacks a fridge with food," Juff noted, turning his face to the panel. "Hang in there for another hour, guys. We'll immediately head for a food establishment to rest. We haven't stopped walking ever since we left the Tessie Club, people."
The two sighed with relief, though Juff thought... They sighed at their hunger. Because talking verbally in secret was not a good thing, Lucario resorted to telepathy.
"Chris, I assume you also heard that voice, right?"
The booming voice? Yes, I heard it.
Oh, good. You two heard me clearly."
Even though they weren't keeping up with things, the duo heard the voice clearer than before. No doubt it was Master Hand himself.
Master Hand?
Chris said, alarmed.
The one and only.
the hand spoke in their minds. Good to see my dimensional telepathy skills are on top of the game. Howdy there, you two otherworldly travellers. I've seen your every move ever since you departed to your long-ass journey to save the universes. Happy to see you two are doing subpar for the moment, he grumbled. I expected more from you, Lucario. You're certainly far stronger than the one I had with me. But geez, you're screwing up even more. Are you sure you're up for this task? I saw everything you've done, like, for example, letting Chris turn into a kid. Lucario winced.
How was I supposed to know that bomb would react like that?
He asked in his defense. Well, I can tell you this. There was no real need for Tabu to develop a bomb like that, the hand said. Bombs don't do that at all. What I can infer is that Ness's world had some sort of influence in how the bomb went off. That or your little assist trophy Juff did a weird number on him on defusing the bomb. By the way, that kid is something. You could learn from him, Chris. Chris winced next.
He's just as experienced as I am. But what he does have is more IQ than I do, machinery-wise.
I think just in general, really. You're a bit of an arrogant prick, frankly.
No excuses, the hand retorted. Afterwards, he sighed. Look, Chris, you're starting to feel like the load for our little team, and I'm starting to regret not giving you a single job to test out your devotion for the rather suicidal choice you so foolishly chose to take on with Lucario, who can kill you if he were so much as to step on your frail little body.
Are you deliberately insulting me? I can't tell, Chris said.
If he is, I will deliberately murder him while you're away so you don't have to faint,
Lucario said in a threatening voice. Empty threats fall in my deaf ears. You don't have ears, you prick. As I was saying, Chris, I feel pity for you, Master Hand said. No way in that body you're going to dish damage. I'm going to go ahead and give you a break. Chris was finally getting a break from the ordeals.
You mean you're going to appear and finish the bad guys off?
Master Hand laughed. And then Crazy Hand joined with a laughing by laughing even louder.
Are you effing kidding me? Doing that will put me in peril with the army.
Oh, what? Oh, no, okay, fine. No, that was actually Master Hand talking. Sorry.
Are you effing kidding me? Doing that will put me in peril with the army. I go out from my hiding spot and Tabu will call the National Guard on my wrist. The death rate in Ness's world will hit the top. You will either puke, faint, or do both and die in your sleep, and Lucario is probably getting a nuke dropped on his head.
Holy crap, Chris said. Is it incredible to say I can totally expect all that to happen at this point?
Seriously, a nuke?
Was all Lucario could say.
Yeah, things will get that crazy. You two are my only hope to keep things under control, and if I have to give you a job, Chris, then it's all better. So...
That was me attempting to snap my fingers. I can't do it very well. Fingers snapping echoed.
Wait, give me a jaw!
Chris was interrupted as he felt something pulsating on his body for a brief moment. It was his erection. That was a fucking lazy, dumbass joke. But the feeling quickly died down. It was a very strange feeling that even alerted Lucario through his aura senses. With a quick scan of his trainer's soul, the aura Pokemon didn't see anything hazardous.
Congrats, Crazy Hand said. You have obtained your first job, the PK Kid, he announced cheerfully. The description says, blast foes with mind attacks, using a variety of elemental skills that only come from your thoughts.
To be honest, Chris felt no different except for the smaller body size.
But I don't feel a difference. Do you really just do anything to me?
Sure I did, the hand said. I just didn't want to make a scene in front of Juff. Look, let me explain here how this works. Chris, your job list has finally obtained a new job. A job stylized to resemble the powers that Ness has. You won't only get his powers, but your appearance will get affected. I left out the part where your body goes through some horrendously painful alterations. So to indicate you're using a job, you'll be wearing the same clothing Ness wears. Don't worry about cosmetic things like shirt size. The job will always fit you with the right size.
Unbelievable, Chris trailed off. This is really happening to me.
What a culture shock, huh? Really, now, all would work out in the end if you add some courage into the mix, the hand said. The hand, for once, encouraged the kid. Since I didn't change your appearance for some security, I'll tell you how to change jobs manually at will.
All you have to do is think hard about changing to the job desired in your mind, and presto, you'll be wearing the job's clothes in an instant. Though not having changed to the job, Chris sighed with some relief. At least I won't be that much of a load to the team now. That is still to be seen, the hand said, confusing the duo. You see that job I just gave you? It only has PK fire for usage. Everything else that Ness has is locked out to you from the start. Bum 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 bum, who gives a shit?